This is Pet Life Radio. Let's talk pets.
Hello, America, and welcome to Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch. Join John and his expert guests with all of your pet questions, concerns, comments, and stories. Now it's time for Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch.
And welcome to Talkin' Pets, heard coast to coast on your favorite radio station. This is Talkin' Pets, and I'm Jon Patch. Joining us is...
Hey there, everybody. This is Jalynn Sidlow from Celestial Custom Dog Services.
The number to call is 844-305-7800. When you call into that number, you'll speak with Quinn, and he'll put you on the air with us. That's 844-305-7800. The show is produced here at the farm by the ever-so-lovely and talented Mr. Zach Budin.
I love it when you call me lovely and talented.
You're welcome.
Thank you, babe.
We have a special friend joining us. She's back, Anouska Jones. We're going to be talking with her live from New Zealand and the book called Spirit, a book of happiness for horse lovers. So if you're a horse lover, stay tuned. Also, her other book is called Patch and Ruby. Find out if there's a reference to that one. But pick up the phone and give us a call at 844-305-7800. This is Talkin' Pets.
Haul out the holly, put up the tree before my spirit falls again. Fill up the stocking, I may be rushing things, but deck the halls again now.
Welcome to Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch. Your today's co-host is the lovely, beautiful, gorgeous redheaded Jalynn Sidlow. I'm your producer, Zach Budin. Give us a call with your pets' questions, comments, and stories at 844-305-7800 and watch us live on Facebook Live at Talkin' Pets Radio. Now here's your favorite pets show, Talkin' Pets.
The fruitcake, it's time we hung some tinsel on that evergreen bough.
And you're listening to Talkin' Pets. Once again, I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Jalynn Sidlow.
And I'm Zach Budin.
Zach, I didn't get that gorgeous, and well, I'm not a redhead, but...
Well, okay, fine. Ready for a little one? A little interlude one?
Yeah, I'll take it.
Welcome to Talkin' Pets with your host, the beautiful, the gorgeous, the stud-like Michelangelo himself, Jon Patch.
Woo!
Hey, it's bigger than that. And the only one that's allowed to call me stud is Betty White.
Oh, that's true. You're right. I spoke out of turn.
Once again, you are listening to Talkin' Pets, and we want to talk to you. We have a special guest joining us, Anouska Jones, and she is live from New Zealand. Hey, Anouska, how you doing?
I'm good, John. How are you?
Wonderful. It's nice to hear your voice again, and I want to introduce you to Julie and Zach.
Hello there.
Hello. I love that New Zealand accent.
I love her accent as well.
Oh,
well,
you're
actually Australian, right?
Yeah, this is the Australian accent. I've only been in New Zealand for 3 weeks now.
Yeah, you moved. You left Australia and you went to... look, I'm already going in that tone. You left Australia and you're actually in New Zealand now.
I have indeed moved to New Zealand.
Where in Australia are we from?
Rural New South Wales. So kind of north of Sydney for a couple of hours and then inland for about an hour.
I got, 30 cousins in Queensland, actually.
All right.
Yeah,
warmer and more tropical
Melbourne
than where I was, but beautiful.
Yes, a couple in Melbourne and a couple in Sydney, actually.
What brought you to New Zealand, Anouska?
My husband and I have always really loved New Zealand whenever we visited, and I had the opportunity to move my work here. So my daughter's still in primary school, and we thought it was good for her to move while she was still young and give it a go. I mean, life's too short not to have an adventure, so... You know, it was just something we wanted to give it a go and try. It's going to be my sixth country that I've lived in third continent. So
fabulous.
I guess for me, I just need to move regularly to keep feeling like I'm alive or something. I'm a bit of a nomad.
Maybe that's the secret I need.
There you go.
Travel, baby. Just travel.
Just travel. Travel's good for the soul.
Loved it.
Yes. You know what? Who is it said it? There's a very famous singer who said, Baz Luhrmann said, go ahead, live in Manhattan, but leave before you become too hard. And live in San Francisco, but leave before you become too soft.
Yeah.
Cool.
Hey, I also wanted to say, my good friend, When Elephants Weep is one of my favorite books out there, and it's been out for a long time. And you know Jeffrey?
I don't.
Yeah, he actually, Jeffrey Mason lives out there in New Zealand. And I'm not sure which side. It was the, okay, if this makes any sense to you. I don't know, New Zealand, never been there, but it's on the opposite side of where that big earthquake was about a year ago.
Okay, so that would be the South Island. So I'm in the South Island as well now. I'm just south.
I'll have to introduce you to.
Oh, thank you. That would be great.
Yeah, he's written several books, and he is like one of my favorite authors in the world. I love this man. He's you know, I've had the opportunity to spend some time in Los Angeles with him, and you know, Tippi Hedren from the Byrds. Like, we were all out together, and that's how I met Jeffrey. And then he's been on the show a number of times, and just a wonderful man. So, and you seem to be coming into our regulars now too.
I know. Thank you for having me back again.
It's great to have you back.
Now, your pleasure.
Do you love horses?
I do. When I was in Australia, I had three of my own.
Oh, wow. Do you have any, or are you going to have any in New Zealand?
No, we're not on a rural property anymore, so it's probably not the right place for us to have horses, but I think I'll keep up the riding once I've settled in a bit more. But my three horses that I had, I found really good homes for them with friends of mine, and I get regular update pics already, so it's kind of like they're still mine. I'm just sharing them with somebody else now.
You know, share the love.
It's actually interesting, too, in your book here, Spirit, A Book of Happiness for Horse Lovers. Beautiful photography. Who took that?
The photography is amazing.
I sourced that from image libraries. So, first of all, I found the quotes, and then I matched the quotes to the pictures, and I just looked through thousands of photographs on various image libraries until I found one that resonated for me with the quote that I paired it with.
There's Robert Smith's Surtees. There is no secret so close as that between a rider and his horse.
Yes.
And beautiful picture. I mean, it's, you know, it's funny because a lot of people will kind of look at a picture and use their own definition.
Mm-hmm.
But I can
exactly
see, yeah, but I can see where your quotes are. I mean, with the pictures that you picked for each one.
And I actually, in the second part of the production of the book, I work quite closely with a designer when we're putting the files together. And most of the time, we would agree that the image and the quote worked. But sometimes he would come at the quote from a completely different perspective and propose a very different image. So it is, as you say, it's very interesting seeing how people respond to those words themselves and what they bring to the quote.
Well, Zach, our producer, is modeling like Vanna White right now. Your book in front of our Facebook Live.
I'll turn the letters.
So if you want to watch us on Facebook Live, you can right now at Talkin' Pets Radio. You can listen there, too, if you wish, but check it out. And we're going to give away a couple of the books, compliments of Anouska Jones. And
yeah, absolutely beautiful.
Spirit, A Book of Happiness for Horse Lovers. For the first two calls that call right now, you're going to get a copy of the book. And it's a great coffee table book as well. And if you love horses, this is the book for you. So give us a buzz at 844-305-7800. You'll speak with Quinn. Just tell him you want the book, and it's yours. 844-305-7800. 844-305-7800. Horse sense is the thing a horse has which keeps it from betting on people. W.C. Fields. And the picture of a horse's eye. You know, I shot a horror film. We were doing a horror trailer one time, and there was this one shot that I actually suggested to the director, and I said, I really think you need to pull in close on this horse and just go right into the horse's eye with the shot, and it was mesmerizing. And this picture in your book reminds me of that shot. So, but we're going to take a little break, Anouska. Don't go away. We'll come right back with Anouska Jones. The number's 844-305-7800. The book is called Spirit, A Book of Happiness for Horse Lovers. If you love horses, you're going to love this book, and we highly recommend that you check it out. It's available in bookstores and online. And, of course, you can get a complimentary copy right now if you call 844-305-7800. 844-305-7800. You'll know Anouska because she's been on with us before from the books called Meow, A Book of Happiness for Cat Lovers, and Woof, A Book of Happiness for Dog Lovers, which are equally as beautiful books, but this horse book is outstanding.
Yeah, it is.
It's beautiful.
844-305-7800. Call right now, whether you're listening on your favorite radio station or listening on Facebook Live. Call and the book is yours. 844-305-7800. This is Talkin' Pets.
Molly, here's your dinner. Zeus, that's not your food.
Don't let that happen to your precious cat. Elevate your cat's eating experience with the Cat Tree Tray. The cat tree tray keeps your cat's food off the floor and conveniently located on the cat tree. It's the perfect way to eat. It's a beautiful wrought iron tray that easily attaches to your cat tree and keeps dogs and other critters out of your cat's dish. A must for multi-pet households. There's a 6-inch tray for large bowls and a 4-inch tray for smaller bowls. Purchase your cat tree tray today. Go right now to cattreetray.com. That's cattreetray.com. cattreetray.com.
Let's Talk Pets on PetLifeRadio.com.
Happy holidays to everybody out there listening across America and beyond. Apparently, we've got some people in Serbia tuned in on Facebook Live.
But, crazy.
Hello, Serbia. But once again, I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Jalen Sidlow.
And I'm Zach Buden.
And of course, everybody out there in New Zealand with Anouska Jones. So, once again, the book is called Spirit, A Book of Happiness for Horse Lovers. We were talking about some quotes and talking about some of the pictures in there. But actually, Anouska, we gave a book away to our buddy George in Othello, Washington, who's listening out there. And George is a faithful listener, and he's getting a copy of the book. And I think he's got a question for you or a comment. So, hey, George, how you doing?
I'm doing good, John. How you doing?
Doing wonderful. Happy holidays, George. How's the dog?
That's the first thing I was going to say. Happy holidays to you. And Mojo's fine. He's barking at you.
Mojo.
How old is Mojo now?
Oh, man. I think it's getting close to 5 years.
Wow.
You've had
I remember when you got him.
Yeah. I remember that.
Well, 5 years flew by.
He still acts like he's a year old.
That's what I remember when you first got him.
Right, me
you
too.
Were like, you were like, you just picked him up.
Time's going by so fast now.
Oh, my gosh.
It is. The older we get, the faster it goes.
Well, it makes it even worse because that means Patch has known me for 10 years.
Oh, no.
That's scary.
Yeah.
But you had a comment about the fires, I think, in California, right?
Yeah, I was wondering what's going to happen to those horses that were... involved in those fires. I guess there was a whole stable of them, or a lot of wild horses running around. There's like 500 or something of them. Are they gonna round them up and find owners for them, or are they gonna do like they did the other pets in these other fires and ship them off to some other state or something?
Well, I know those horses that died in the barn. There were 29 horses that died in the barn last week. Actually, I did see today that there is going to be a trial. They are going to press charges against, I think, the people that own them.
For not letting them loose.
For not letting them loose and that the paddocks were not open.
Oh.
Anouska, when there's horses involved, because you were a horse owner, tattoo or...
Brand.
Oh, thank you, Zach. Brand the horses so they know who they belong to? Is there a way of identifying? Is there microchips or anything like that done on horses?
In Australia, when the bushfires used to hit, which is the same as your wildfires, we'd obviously open gates and, you know, let the horses loose. But quite a lot of people would put, I'm not sure what you call it, but liquid white paper and write phone numbers on the horse's hooves because that doesn't come off, so that if they're found, that people would call that number.
That's ingenious.
Because not all of the horses are branded. You know, if you're not a racehorse or a pedigree or, you know, warm blood or something like that, you don't generally tend to have a brand in Australia as much. But they would use indelible marker in some way on the horse, usually the phone number, so that if they were found, that they could be contacted.
Well, hopefully they're doing something like that. George, I didn't hear too much more about the wild horses, but, you know, with everything that's going on in the world and they're rounding them up and slaughtering a lot of wild horses the way it is, that's sad in itself, besides the fact that there's fires out there in California, which is horrific.
Now they're letting them go over and shoot elephants again and bringing them...
Yeah.
That's
it's a scary world. It is.
Yeah. It's getting worse every day.
It's a scary political world right now, too. Very.
That's what I mean. Exactly. Got to figure it out, John. Anyway, how did your friend's tigers get... Did she have any trouble keeping her tigers locked up? Or
Yep.
Actually, no, I did speak with Tippi the other day, and she's not affected by the fires. But, you know, right. We were talking, and she does have an evacuation plan, of course, in place, which most people should, and some people don't. Mm-hmm. But she does have one in place that if she has to evacuate the lions and the tigers, she can do that.
Hey, are you getting good weather there in Florida?
It's warm today.
It's beautiful today. I'm sorry.
Today. It's below freezing here, and we're getting like 3 inches of snow right now.
Oh, you can have it.
Well, we remember what happened the last time John was in cold weather.
Yeah, no, that's not good. Well, George, right, thanks so much, and enjoy the book. We'll get that out to you. Compliments
sure
of Anouska Jones.
You guys have a happy holidays, too.
You okay? Too, George.
Good talking to you again. Thank you. Mojo says bye. Thank you. Bye.
Bye, Mojo.
Bye, Mojo.
That's George out there in Othello, Washington. Once again, you're listening to Talkin'
Pets. That's
pick up the phone and give us a call. We want to talk to you at 844-305-7800. I have another book to give away, Compliments of Anouska Jones, and the book is called Spirit, a Book of Happiness for Horse Lovers. And the book is yours, just like with George, if you call 844-305-7800. We won't force you to come on the air with this. It's Compliments of Anouska and also the publishing company, which is it's Exile Publishing, correct?
Correct. That's right, yes.
And you have another book, too. I did not get a copy of it, but I did do a little research on it. And ironically, it's called Patch and Ruby?
Yes, it is. I'm afraid I didn't name it after you, but I did name it
after
my
Darn, I thought
own
maybe
brother.
You did.
No, two of my horses were called Patch and Ruby, and so this one is actually a children's picture book aimed at kids probably around the 4 to 8 age year range. And it's just a story of a lonely horse called Patch who doesn't have anyone that he feels that he can really get along with. He tries to hang with the chickens, but they don't really like talking to him because he's a bit big. And he tries to hang in the vegetable garden, but nobody's thrilled with him weeding the carrots. And then
she
one
didn't
day
write
another
this book about me.
you and me.
Maybe
for
I'm
carrots,
channeling you
one,
somehow. And then another horse arrives called Ruby. And so basically Patch finds the right friend for him. And I was actually inspired to write that because I used to help a friend of mine who ran a program for children with autism working with horses. Because a lot of the autistic children just didn't really feel like they belonged or that they were accepted, whereas horses, of course, offer unconditional acceptance. And watching the kids relax and open up and communicate when they were around the horses was just such a beautiful way of how if you feel comfortable and you're in the right spot, you can really be you. That's what inspired me to write this story, but I just turned it around so that it was a horse who found the right friend so that he could be him.
And that's also put out by Exile Publishing as well, so you can find it in bookstores and online, and I think we can give one or two of those away as well. So if you want to call and you want the children's book called Patch and Ruby, Compliments of Anouska Jones, who has written the book and all, illustrations by Gwyneth Jones, Patch and Ruby, the book is yours. It's my story. Just kidding. 844-305-7800. 844-305-7800. Call right now, and Patch and Ruby, the book is yours for your kids. So it could be a great stocking stuffer as well. So we recommend the book, Patch and Ruby, but definitely, of course, Spirit, a Book of Happiness for Horse Lovers. And Anouska, I want to thank you for calling in from New Zealand, and I really look forward to staying more in touch with you. And I love your books, and I love what you do, and it's always a joy talking with you.
Always.
Thank you so much, John, and I wish you all very wonderful holidays and a great 2018.
Well, congratulations once again on a great book, Spirit. I mean, I love this book. And Patch and Ruby, children's books are always phenomenal. So congratulations.
Thank you, John. You take care.
You too. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Bye.
That's Anouska Jones. She is the author of the books, of course, Spirit, a Book of Happiness for Horse Lovers. It's full of quotes, and we gave you a couple of them in the beginning. But there's much, much more in here, and the photography is just outstanding. So if you're a horse lover... Jillie, I don't know if you got a chance to look at in the middle of the book. I don't see the page. But anyway,
page for page.
The quote is, as a horse runs, think of it as a game of tag with the wind.
Yes.
And gorgeous picture.
Yeah.
I mean, the picture is outstanding. So I see you're calling for the books. So if you want the book Spirit, it's yours. Or Patch and Ruby, that's yours as well. Once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets.
To be jolly, hear the bells of Christmas call. Deck the halls with boughs of holly. La 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 la.
He was mal.
malnourished and emaciated.
Constant scratching and just being unpleasant.
He was shedding excessively.
He was losing his fur.
Franklin was rescued from the streets of Los Angeles.
Bear was a rescue from the same shelter in Kansas City, Missouri that I got JJ the Terrier.
I found his raw meat diet, which is raw meat, eggs, rice, and Dynavite and Lico Chops. His omega-3 supplement on Dynavite.com.
Dinovite.com.
I've got my ground beef, the Dynavite, and I just mix it all together with the eggs and the shells.
Franklin, he's thriving. His coat is soft and shiny. He's shedding much less.
They're much happier. Their coats are better. Their behavior, especially their behavior, is better. How do you feed your shelter dog to derive a great attitude?
Start that little pet off right.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
Just go to Dinovite.com.
Dinovite.com.
Let's talk pets.
Let's talk pets.
On Pet Life Radio.
Pet Life Radio.
PetLifeRadio.com.
This hour's Talking Pets news from the USA Today. Here's your host, Jon Patch.
And speaking for me is Jalyn Sidlow.
Scientists have previously shown that a parasite from cats can infect people's brain and affect behavior. Now researchers at Stockholm University have discovered how the parasite takes control of our cells. We have decoded how the parasite takes control of immune cells, converting them into moving zombies, which spread the parasite into the body, said Antonio Barragan, professor of Stockholm University and one of the authors of the new study. The infection, toxoplasmosis, is caused by the parasite Toxoplasma gondii and is widely spread. It is estimated that 30 to 50% of the global human population are carriers. Cats are the parasite's main host, but the infection is also spread among other animals, including humans. A series of studies have previously shown that the parasite affects the brain of affected rats so that they lose fear of cats and have become attracted to cats' smell, making them easy prey. This is how the parasite is spread onward, by ensuing that the rat by eaten by the cat. Toxoplasmosis is life-threatening to people with impaired immune systems and to unborn fetuses, but causes only mild symptoms in healthy individuals. However, there are studies showing that mental illness such as schizophrenia, depression, and anxiety disorder are more common in people who are carriers of Toxoplasma gondii. There are also studies indicating that the parasite may affect aggressive or risky behavior. Researchers at Stockholm University have now been able to show how a parasite takes control and force immune cells around the body to spread it, eventually reaching the brain. When we become infected with toxoplasma, the example by eating insufficiently cooked meat or by contact with cat feces, the parasite ends up in the stomach. It then passes through the intestinal wall and is met by immune cells that would normally kill it. Instead, immune cells become Trojan horses by secreting the substance GABA. They are spread and infect the entire body. It is a coincidence, or is it evolution? It resembles how nerve cells speak to each other in our brains. The new research has shown that the small calcium molecule in the messenger is in the communication. The researchers have found that a new calcium receptor on immune cells acting as a mailbox to receive the parasite's order for the cell to move. The neat thing is that the signal can be inhibited by regular blood pressure medicine. When mice received this medicine, the spread of the parasite was inhibited. We do not want to say that the blood pressure medicine can cure toxoplasmosis, but we have discovered a new signaling pathway in immune cells that are linked to the mortality and that their parasite utilizes a very smart way.
In New Illinois, divorce law would give pet custody to better owners. A new Illinois divorce law will let a judge decide who is the best owner for the family pet. Previously, companion animals were treated like furniture in a divorce. They were divided up between the splitting couple as part of the value of the estate. But on January 1st, the judge will now be able to consider who walks the dog more or who cleans out the fish tank and award the pet accordingly. The law, sponsored by State Senator Linda Holmes, Democrat from Aurora, is meant to treat pets less like property and more like family. It has feelings and emotions, Holmes said. They're looking at what would be the best interest of the animal. Holmes, who served as Brookfield Zoo Dockage and volunteers with the Naperville Humane Society, said both sides would make theirs. It's as to why they would be the best to keep the pet. The judge would, in theory, be able to grant joint custody of the pup, cat, rat, fish, whatever it may be. The law would not apply to service animals. Divorce attorney and animal rights advocate Erica Wyatt, partner of Schiller, Ducanto, and Fleck, said it would now matter who does the dirty work of caring for a pet, if you want to consider it dirty work. Who does the day-to-day stuff? Who buys the pet food? Who stays on top of vaccinations, she said. Anything that happens in the normal care of the pet is going to become irrelevant now. Animal custody was becoming more common in a courtroom battle up until the last couple years. A study by the American Academy of Matrimonial Lawyers showed that a third of their lawyers said couples divorced in the last 3 years were more likely to settle pet custody disputes outside of the courtroom. Dogs, they said, remain the top animal causing these disputes with 96% of the respondents. Cats and horses come in a distant second with 1% each. Alaska was the first to change its divorce laws to give pets a higher status in divorce proceedings. Visit TalkinPets.com for more information and to join our social network and watch us live Saturdays 5 to 8 p.m. Eastern Time on Facebook Live at Talkin' Pets Radio and listen to our podcast at TalkinPets.com /archives. Right now, you're listening to Talkin' Pets.
I'm gonna keep on living, even though I sometimes do fantasize about disappearing down in the ocean blue, just to get some peace and quiet from the warfare inside my heart. Well, I've been under ear-splitting fire ever since we've been apart. Well, I'm gonna wash the dishes, pay the bills and watch the news. I got the tough education, no celebration, divorce, separation, blues. Deodorly, deodorly.
Can you yodel?
I can.
Let me hear.
Oh my goodness, seriously?
Apparently he can. That's the Abbott Brothers.
Oh, yeah.
It's called True Sadness.
Yodeling.
Yodeling. Yodeling.
I want to go ahead and, like, stand on top of a mountain and start doing that.
Yeah, really. But you need a good echo.
Yodeling.
Yodeling.
Wow.
That's pretty good.
Yodeling. Yeah. I'm German.
Who do? Who do? Do who?
Who do you do? Who you do?
Hey, once again, you are listening to Talkin' Pets. Pick up the phone and give us a call. We want to talk to you, as I lose my voice, about your pets at 844-305-7800. 844-305-7800. That is the number to call if you've got a question about your pets. But we still have another book. We gave away the Patch and Ruby books, Compliments of Anouska Jones. That's her new book about kids. It's about horses and getting along and so on and so forth. She recommended it for 4 to 8 year olds. And that's coming out to two of our listeners there, one in Oregon and one in Vancouver. So congratulations to them. And so I do have another spirit book to give away, A Book of Happiness for Horse Lovers.
I love this book.
It's a beautiful book. So call, and it is yours. Zach, you want to demonstrate some pictures from the book on our Facebook Live?
I would love to, Vanna White it up.
You can watch on Facebook Live right now at Talkin' Pets Radio, and you can see some of the pictures that are actually
this
the photography that's in
go
the book.
On my coffee table. I've been, you know, privy to have some wonderful books come off this radio station, but I'm telling you, this is one of my favorites. I know, isn't that hilarious?
Zach, you got to find this one and hold it up close
it's
up
so
to
fun
the Facebook. It is hysterical.
What is it? What page?
I'm not sure. Does that have a page? Oh, it does. Yeah. 103.
103.
Yeah, he's going to hold up a picture that I think
pull
is
up 103
absolutely hysterical.
Go figure. I just turned right to it.
844-305-7800. Call right now, and the book is yours. 844-305-7800. We also have, it's the holidays, and graciously, Workman Publishing has given us some giveaways, calendar giveaways for 2018.
Woo-hoo!
And we're going to give away each a calendar.
And I'm the president of calendars.
And just so that Quinn knows, our producer, they do have the name, so we need to mark it by name because make sure that we get that down when the person calls and wins. So I'll start with my calendar.
Meow.
I'm going to start with, it's Bad Cat. Grandma, what big whiskers you have. So that is the one that I am going to give away. It's called Bad Cat. So basically, Bad Cat is a rude walk on the feline wild side. Here are cats going rogue in places where they shouldn't be, in sinks and toilets and houseplants. Here are cats plotting escapes, warding off children, scamming their owners, yet still expecting to be spoiled and rotten. Sneaky cats, fat cats, naughty cats, bored cats, and perhaps worst of all, cats plotting revenge for all of those costumes they were forced to wear during the holidays. Ho, ho, ho. With bonus features such as Bad Cat Beauty Secrets, Least Wanted Bad Cat Diet Secrets, Who's Who in Bad Cats, and Bad Cat Early Warning Signs. So if you want the 2018 calendar by Workman Publishing, compliments of Workman Publishing, it's yours. But you got to call and get it right now. Be the second call to speak with Quinn. And I'm holding it up to our Facebook Live in case you're on there. And it's called Bad Cats. And that is coming out to you, the second caller, at 844-305-7800. So you don't have to buy your calendar. It is here. And you can also, if you want to buy it, though, you can get it at workman.com, Amazon, Barnes & Noble has it, Book a Million, and IndieBound. So some of the places where you can get Workman Publishing calendars. But this one's free, and it goes to the second caller at 844-305-7800. And it is called 2018 Calendar Bad Cat.
I love that. On the back, oh, behave.
Julie, oh, behave.
You know, it's
are
also
you horny,
funny.
Baby?
Are you?
Do I make you horny, baby? Yeah.
So that one's called Bad Cat.
That's
so
cool.
Call right now and it's yours. 844-305-7800. Real quick, you got one, Julie?
I do. I have chosen the 2018 The Doggiest.
The Doggiest.
By Elias Weiss Friedman.
So that's actually a book, too, that came out. And that one actually, Doggiest, if I can find that one on here. You surprised me. Okay, well, what we'll do is we'll give away the Doggiest. She's holding it up to Facebook Live. If you are the third caller and call in with that one, you get the Doggiest. So here it is. Wall calendar 2018. Nobody captures dogs like the Doggiest, a.k.a. photographer Elias Weiss Friedman, author of the New York Times best-selling book, The Doggiest. The Instagram phenomenon with over 2 million followers and climbing, Friedman had a gift for getting down on a dog's level and in a few quick snaps of his camera, finding the individual spirit of the animals he's photographing. The result? Warm, heartfelt, arrestingly beautiful, candid portraits of dogs on the street in all their variety and glory. Now in its second year, it is called The Doggiest. And that is coming out to you if you call right now. 844-305-7800. When we come back, Zach's going to give away one of his calendars from Workman Publishing. So stay tuned for that. You can get them at workman.com, Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Book a Million, and IndieBound. But right now, Bad Cat is yours, and The Doggiest is yours if you call, and you'll have your 2018 calendars mailed to you.
Woohoo!
Schwing.
Compliments of Workman Publishing and Talkin' Pets. 844-305-7800. Speak with Quinn. We're going to take a break, and we'll be right back.
It's DesignerPetSweaters.com. Hand-knitted designer sweaters for your precious pup or cool cat. Beautiful couture patterns for your pets, including custom-knitted formal wear, casual wear, yachting, and even sports-themed. Many designer pet sweaters include feathered tammy hats, top hats, and a lot of sparkle. Each sweater includes leg loops, front paw sleeves, and leash opening. Visit DesignerPetSweaters.com to order your four-legged fashions today. Your pets will stay warm for the winter and be runway ready. Large or small, we fit them all. DesignerPetSweaters.com.
Begging to hear more of your favorite show? Full episodes of all our shows are available on demand. Go to PetLifeRadio.com to fetch our entire lineup of Possum Pet Podcasts. Also, dig us up in iHeartRadio and iTunes. Let's talk pets. Live and on demand, only from Pet Life Radio. Let's Talk Pets.
Let's Talk Pets.
On Pet Life Radio.
Pet Life Radio.
PetLifeRadio.com.
Shark dragging video case results in three Florida arrests. Among the three men charged is Michael Wenzel, 21, of Palmetto, who was captain of the boat and a friend of Alex Kampathakras, star of MTV reality show Siesta Key. Wenzel faces two felony counts of aggravated animal cruelty and one misdemeanor for using an illegal method to catch a shark. The felony counts are each punishable by up to 5 years in prison and up to $10,000 fine, although any punishment will likely be less than the maximum. Robert Lee Bo Bronk, 28, of Bradenton, faces the same felony and misdemeanor charges as Wenzel. He is the son of Manatee County Commission Chair Betsy Bonock, while Wenzel is the son of the County Planning Director. The third man charged is Spencer Heights, 23, also of Palmetto, who faces just the two felony charges. All three turned themselves in on Tuesday. Wenzel was booked into the Pinellas County Jail at 12:30 p.m. and freed at 7 p.m. after posting $4,250 in bail, according to the records. Bonock was released from the Hillsborough County Jail Tuesday at 10:30 p.m. after posting $4,250 bail. The state's attorney office is committed to holding these men accountable for having engaged in such senseless and unjustifiable animal cruelty. Visit Talking Pets and for more information and join us on our social network and watch us live Saturdays from 5 to 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time and on Facebook Live at Talking Pets Radio and listen to our podcast at TalkingPets.com, gallery and archives. Reporting from Talking Pets, this is Jalen Sidlow.
And once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Jalen Sidlow.
And I'm Zach Buden.
Congratulations my screen went by already. But in Evanston, we had a winner in Evanston, Illinois, who got the kids' book, children's book,
awesome.
Patch and Ruby. Also the doggist. And I believe Bill and Shelton got the bad cats.
Ow!
So now we have the heart-melting, best-selling pocket pigs calendar ever is back. Each month, Pennywell Farms' famously tiny teacup pigs attend to their favorite hobbies, hemming clothes on a sewing machine, carrying clubs to a big game of golf, peeping through a telescope in appropriately tiny proportions. Pigs checking email, pigs snuggling in flower bushels, pigs getting chummy with other farm animals. Sure, you'd like to carry these pocket-sized friends around in your palm. A close second best is admiring them on your wall year-round with
Pocket Piggies.
The Pocket Piggies calendar 2018 is the number two caller right now. Compliments of Workman Publishing. If you like cute pigs, then you're going to want this calendar.
It's the Pocket Pigs. The famous teacup pigs of Pennywell Farm.
So, and if you want to purchase, you can go to workman.com or they have it on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Book A Million, and IndieBound. But right now, this calendar is yours.
Piggies. The little piggies. It's called Pocket Piggies.
I'm sorry. I like saying it.
I just haven't, you know.
He's the little piggies.
I don't know. Julie's throwing her garbage at me. She's opening up.
Opening up another calendar that I'm loving over here.
All right. That's for another one. But, that one's actually got a cool base in there.
Yeah.
That's like a tearaway calendar.
Well, that's for next hour. But once again, call right now, and Piggies is yours. Pocket Piggies calendar.
Piggies!
844-305-7800. 844-305-7800. And Pocket Piggies calendar 2018 is yours.
Which one are we giving away right now, real quick?
Pocket Piggies.
Piggies!
Pocket Piggies. Oink, oink, oink. Call and it's yours. 844-305-7800. And happy holidays from all of us here. So call and it's yours. Number two caller, 844-305-7800.
Didn't you ever want a piggy?
You know, the problem with the piggies, though, piggies are adorable, and they're very intelligent and very smart, so it's really sad that they get slaughtered.
I agree.
I do like pork, though.
Me too.
Bacon's good.
Bacon. bacon.
Not exactly good for you, but but it tastes good. And I'm sorry, I feel bad for the pigs, but they are very intelligent creatures.
Chocolate-covered bacon.
Okay, now we're going too far.
We're going, I don't know. It's making me sad.
They're very, very smart.
Yes, they
are. But they're so cute.
They make great pets.
They do. Actually, they do. If you can house like a 400-pound pig in your house.
Well, the little tiny ones.
No, they get big.
The teacups get a lot bigger than most people think.
Yes. People think that the pigs stay tiny, like shoebox tiny. No.
No, they don't.
No. You're going to have to bury them in a piano box. So.
Put off a slab of pork right there.
They get to be big piggies. But they're very nice, and they're actually very clean.
Yeah.
I mean, they don't have to throw themselves in mud and everything, but, you know, a good mud bath once in a while is good for us all. Cleans your pores.
Absolutely. I roll around in the dirt every so often.
I bet you do.
Really, baby.
844-305-7800, 844-305-7800. But thanks for listening to this hour of Talking Pets. And if you call right now, Pocket Piggies is yours, a bottle of Scoey10X, the ultimate odor eliminator, and a bottle of Nutrix for your older dog or cat to bring back focus in their life. And they need it. So they've been with you all these years. Give them the love that they deserve with Nutrix, because they do need it. My cat Rainey had it for the last 3 years of her life, and she lived to be 19, and she was as alert as could be.
Oh, yeah.
She wasn't when she was in her like mid-teens. I thought I was going to lose her then, but then I put her on Nutrix, and she was running around the house like a little kid. So they're yours. Call right now, and it's yours. 844-305-7800. And if you're going to get a pig in your life, and we're talking about the oink oink kind.
Not the one I just kicked to the curb.
Yeah, not that one. You know, make sure you realize that they do get big. All right, little piggies. Time to say goodbye for this hour of Talking Pets. Spay and neuter your pets and help control that pet population. Happy holidays.
Bye, y'all.
A big thank you to Anouska Jones, with the author of Spirit, A Book of Happiness for Horse Lovers, and Patch and Ruby, her children's book. Congratulations, Anouska. Love her. She's so wonderful.
She's awesome.
And now in New Zealand. But once again, thanks for joining us here on Talking Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Jalen Sidlow.
And I'm Zach Bude.
Spay and neuter those pets, help control the pet population. If you want to purchase a pet, go to your local shelter or rescue group and get one there. And think twice about giving them as presents during the holidays, unless you, who is the giver, wants to take care of them for the rest of their lives. Once again, this is Talkin' Pets.
Let's Talk Pets, every week on demand, only on PetLifeRadio.com.